हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 7 एंड इन चैप्टर नंबर 7 आई एम टेकिंग टुडे हेट्रोजीनस हाइड्रोजनेशन एंड होमोजेनस हाइड्रोजनेशन, राइट। सो फर्स्ट वी विल टेक हाउ दिस हेट्रोजीनस हाइड्रोजनेशन टेक प्लेस एंड व्हाट आर सम इम्पॉर्टेंट स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री पॉइंट्स अबाउट दैट, राइट। सो फर्स्ट एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज द हेट्रोजीनस हाइड्रोजनेशन इज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इज सिस टाइप। This type means both the hydrogen atoms will be added on the same side of the double bond, right? Cis addition, and it is from the less hindered side. This is the most important point about this. Then we will take some examples based on it. Suppose this one is our alkene and it is E-alkene, right? So if we are going to do its hydrogenation, what are the possibilities? That suppose this is my bond and I am attaching hydrogen here. Two hydrogens on the same side. Now this phenyl, this can come above the plane and methyl can go below the plane, or on second and the second carbon we have the possibility that this pH will go below the plane and methyl will come above the plane. This is the one possibility. Another possibility can be that this phenyl will go below the plane, this methyl will come above the plane, vice versa on this carbon, right? And if we are following this approach, we will get two type of products here, and these two are racemic of each other, right? So in this case we will get racemic mixture plus minus product in case of E-alkene. But if we are taking our Z-alkene, then we will get mesotype product, right? Because both the phenyl will go on the same side, either it is below the plane or above the plane, we will get mesotype of product. So suppose in this case I have taken hydrogen given by this palladium, supported on palladium, similarly in this case, and this is our Z-alkene, so it will give me meso compound, it will give me racemic mixture. Then we have studied here that the attack will be from the less hindered side, right? So in this example, suppose I am using platinum oxide here, Adams catalyst, which is also called as Adams catalyst. So when I am using hydrogen for this compound, we have here ketone, so it will be reduced to OH, right? It will be converted into alcohol. So question comes that H will attack from this side or it will attack from this side, right? So this is our less hindered side, because at this side we have methyl which can cause diazoxal interaction. So it will not attack from this side, H will attack from this side. In major product, we will get H attached to the equatorial side and OH will go axially. We should not look at the final product yet, right? We can think that this OH can show diazoxal interaction with this methyl, so this will not be our major product, but we should look at the reagent. That reagent should attack from the less hindered side, whatever the product we are getting, but the reagent should attack from the less hindered side. So we will get 83% of it, and in rest amount we will get this H attached axially. Then there are also some cases in which certain groups promotes addition of hydrogen to their same side, right? We have studied in case of allylic alcohol that whenever we are doing epoxidation, they favors attachment of oxygen on the same side of OH, right? We have studied this thing. Similarly, in this case also, when we have R as suppose CH2OH, if it is CH2OH, then it will promote attachment of this hydrogen on this hydrogen on this carbon on the same side to that of R, right? Means we have two possibilities here. This will be our compound after hydrogenation, right? We will get hydrogen attached on these two carbon. Now question comes that what will be the side of attachment of this H? So if this R is equals to CH2OH, then suppose this R is above the plane, then these two hydrogens will also attach above the plane, right? And if it is below the plane, then it will go below the plane. So this will be our major product. We will also get some amount of product in which this R will go below the plane, but in this case it is on the in the major product it is on the same side of R. For example, if my R is equal to CH2OH, then this major product will be 95%, and if I am using in place of this I have a ester, then this will become 15%. The most common type of example for this, the most common group for this type of example is CH2OH. Then next thing is, I have told you that there is cis addition of hydrogen. In most of the time, in 99% cases, two hydrogen attaches on the same side of double bond, right? But in certain cases, it is also possible that you will get trans product. When it will happen? When you have substituted cyclic alkenes. And this is shown by mainly palladium catalysts. So this point is very, very important, that it is shown by palladium catalyst. If you have any other catalyst, generally platinum is used, then it will show cis addition. But when you have this palladium and this double bond is, this alkene is substituted, cyclic alkene is substituted, then you will get trans product. So in this case, this will be your major product. This transdecalene will be your major product. Right, and in this case, this will be your 79%, and you will get also some amount of product in which these two hydrogens on the same side, means cis product. This is only 21%. For example, in this case, when I will do reduction, I can have two possibilities, this one or I can have this product. Right, this is according to the concept we have studied so far, that there is cis addition of hydrogen and this is our trans addition. Right, and if so, when we will get which will be our major product? Suppose I am using palladium, then this will be the major product. This will be your 46% amount and this will form 16%. And when you are using platinum oxide, then this will become your 18% and this will be 82%, right? So this case is especially for palladium catalyst. Let's move to some important type of heterogeneous catalysts first. I have designed this chapter in different way, that in karyotherapy they have given you different type of functional groups, and then they have told you that how different type of catalyst can be used there, right? But I think this is the more easier way. If you take one catalyst first and then you study its properties, right? It is my way of studying, and if you don't find it more comfortably, you can use Carruthers book, right? First you can understand by it, then you can follow the Carruthers book. So first we will take platinum. So in case of platinum, you can have two type of catalyst, that you can have platinum as a catalyst only, or you can have platinum oxide, which is called as Adams catalyst, right? So we will take its properties one by one. So most important use of this platinum oxide is that it will do reduction of alkene without affecting other functional groups, right? Reduction of alkene without affecting other functional groups. So we have here two esters, but they will not be affected, only this double bond will be reduced, right? Next question comes, that what will be the attachment side of hydrogens? Two hydrogens will be added by the syn addition, means on the same side, right? But this phenyl, which is below the plane, will govern the attacking side of this catalyst. So the hydrogen will tries to attach from the less hindered side, means away from this phenyl, means hydrogens will attach above the plane and these two groups will go below the plane, right? So this is the one thing. Then question comes, that if you have more than one double bond in a molecule, then what you will do? Always remember, terminal alkenes reduced first, right? So if you are using a limited amount of this platinum oxide and hydrogen, suppose only one equivalent, then only this double bond, this terminal double bond will be reduced first. So you will get this type of product. But at the same time, if you are using this type of molecule, then you will get this one as final product. Both double bond will be reduced because both are terminal in nature. So both will be reduced, Next thing comes that if you have benzene or its derivatives, then they will be reduced by this catalyst. So we will get, suppose, cyclohexane here. In this case, first you will get this type of product, then it can show cyclization by attack on this carbon, and then finally this nitrogen will be removed as ammonia, right? So you will get this type of product. Then next property is for platinum only. We are getting using platinum only. So the platinum can reduce double bond, it can reduce triple bond, right? It can reduce both. So if I have this type of a structure, when I have this triple bond and in addition to that I have OH group at the alpha carbon, this is very important that if you have OH hydroxyl group on alpha carbon of triple bond, then this platinum will show hydrogenolysis. Now what is hydrogenolysis? If you know, then it is very good. If you don't know, then you can understand that there is breakage of bond between carbon and hetero atom. If you have carbon and hetero atom means you can have oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur. So certain catalyst, we will see how other catalyst can do this properly. Then suppose I will take palladium over carbon, then palladium over carbon can do it very efficiently, then it can break this carbon hetero atom bond. So it is basically used for deprotection of protecting group, removal of protecting group, right? So platinum doesn't show this type of property, but if you have OH on alpha carbon of triple bond, then it can show hydrogenolysis. So this point is very, very important. So if it will do hydrogenolysis, means you will get this type of product, this OH will remain as such, but this will be removed and this triple bond will be reduced to alkane. Then we will take Rani nickel, then we will take Rene nickel. So it is also called, denoted as RANI. So this catalyst is also very important, but its efficiency is dependent upon temperature. So this Rene nickel can reduce ketones, aldehydes, alkenes, alkynes, nitriles, nitro compounds to amines, nitriles to amines, and then it can reduce aromatics. And for reduction of aromatic compounds, high temperature and high pressure conditions are generally used, right? In this case, it is given in Carruthers that at 50 degrees centigrade it can reduce this phenyl ring and convert it into cyclohexane, right? But most of the time a reduction of aromatics take place at very, very high temperature. For example, for naphthalene, 150 to 200 degrees centigrade temperature is used and the pressure is also very high. So if I am using a moderate type of temperature, moderately high type of temperature, then I will get this type of product. And if I will further increase temperature and pressure, then it will be completely reduced, right? So these are the important points about this. So please remember that this Rene nickel can reduce what type of functional groups. Then next point is, if I am using low temperature condition, for example, we have only 20 degrees centigrade, that it will reduce only this double bond. This aromatic ring will remain unaffected. Only this double bond is reduced and it can convert triple bond directly to hydrocarbons, directly to alkenes. Next catalyst is palladium over carbon. It is very, very important because it is generally asked in examination. So first we will take that it will do selective reduction of double bond in presence of other functional group. First point is, it will do selective reduction of double bond, and most of the time those reagents are useful which will do selective reduction. Platinum, Rene nickel and platinum do all type of reduction. They can do reduction of all type of functional groups mostly, but this palladium over carbon is very, very selective. That is why it is more important, right? So it will do selective reduction of double bond in presence of other functional group. So it is very easy to understand. But suppose we will take this example. So question comes that we have to reduce this double bond and this double bond. We have two double bonds here, both of them will be reduced. So question comes that what will be the attachment site of your hydrogen. So if you look at this compound, then this hydrogen is below the plane. So you can consider this ring slightly this type. It is not so much like this. It is not like this because this is a 7-membered ring. So it will be slightly planar in nature, but it has somewhat structure like this, right? So because of this cyclopentene ring, so because of this structure, the attack of catalyst will not be from the side of cavity. It will be always away from the cavity side, right? From this side. That is why hydrogen on both the double bond will attack from below the plane side, right? So you will get hydrogen attached here and both the hydrogen will go below the plane, right? You will get this type of structure because this is, there is syn addition. That is why the addition of hydrogen is taking place from the same side. Both sides are below the plane, right? Then next property is that it will show hydrogenolysis, which I have told you earlier, that it can show breakage of carbon heteroatom bond. This is our carbon and this is heteroatom. So this bond can be cleaved by this palladium over carbon, and it is very, very important property because it can show removal of protecting group. This bond, this carbon heteroatom, this heteroatom can be oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, halogen, right? So it can show removal of this. So in this case, what you will get, this one is final product. But suppose if you don't want to do hydrogenolysis with this palladium over carbon, but at the same time you want only reduction of your double bond, right? Means in a molecule you have double bond as well as a heteroatom protected by a protecting group, and you want only reduction of double bond. For example, in this case you have double bond here and this nitrogen is protected by this CBZ group. Now you don't want to remove this group, only want to reduce this double bond. Then you can use palladium over carbon in presence of this ligand ethylene diamine. Then it will not do its hydrogenolysis. It will remain as such. Only this double bond will be reduced. And I think this example is very, very important because it is slightly different than others. The next point is, we have studied that it will do selective reduction of double bond in presence of other groups. Means we can have carbonyl group, we can have nitrile, nitro group. These all will remain unaffected. Only double bond is reduced, right? So in this case, this carbonyl remain unaffected. If I am using platinum in place of this palladium over carbon, suppose I am using platinum, so this carbonyl group will be reduced to OH and this double bond is also reduced, right? So if I am using this palladium over carbon, this carbonyl group will remain unaffected, only this double bond is reduced. But this case is not for triple bond. If I have triple bond, then it will be reduced by this palladium over carbon. Then some exceptions are also there. Triple bond, aromatic nitro group. Aromatic nitro group is reduced by palladium over carbon. In addition to that, we have acyl chloride group. Acyl chloride group can also be reduced. So these can be reduced, right? For example, suppose I have this this one in which this nitro group is attached with this benzene ring by this double bond, right? So when I am using this palladium over carbon, this nitro group is reduced first than this double bond. Its reduction will take place more faster than this double bond, right? In final product, this double bond is also reduced, but NO2 is also reduced to amine. And this nitrile group is reduced by platinum, palladium, rhenium, nickel, all can reduce it to amine. Then another catalyst related to this palladium is Lidlar catalyst, and we all know about this Lidlar catalyst, that it is palladium over calcium carbonate, which is deactivated by quinoline, right? What it can do, it can convert your alkynes into Z alkene. So I'm not going in detail of it. You all know about this Lindlar catalyst, right? Then next is rhodium and ruthenium catalyst. These are heterogeneous catalyst of rhodium and ruthenium. I'm not talking about homogeneous catalyst of rhodium and ruthenium. We will take them a little bit later, but first we will take their heterogeneous catalysis. So why these are important? Because they can do selective reduction of double bond without doing hydrogenolysis. We have seen that we can use palladium over carbon, which is very good for selective reduction, but it has some drawbacks that it can do hydrogenolysis with reduction of double bond, right? So we can also use this rhodium over alumina or ruthenium over alumina. So these catalysts can show reduction without doing hydrogenolysis. So they will only reduce this double bond. This double bond is reduced to alkane. Only this one will be done. Suppose for this case, we have seen this example previously. So only this benzene ring is reduced. This OH will remain unaffected. If I were using this palladium over carbon here, then this benzene ring is not reduced, but this hydrogenolysis take place here. But if I am using this rhodium with alumina, then you will get only reduction of double bond. So I have written only here rhodium and alumina, these cases, but you can have other conditions also, temperature, pressure conditions, but you have to understand the use of these catalysts. In this case, we have here rhodium alumina, as well as we have here Jones reagent. Jones reagent is chromium tetraoxide in presence of sulfuric acid. So first we will do reduction. Reduction means only this double bond will be reduced. Only these double bonds will be reduced. And then this OH will be oxidized by this Jones catalyst to ketone group. Now in major product, you will get cis addition of these two methyl groups. Major product contains cis addition of these two methyls. Now we will come to homogeneous hydrogenation. So when we are studying homogeneous hydrogenation, the most important example is Wilkinson catalyst. So we will take here Wilkinson catalyst, as well as we will take some other homogeneous catalyst like ruthenium catalyst and iridium catalyst, because in recent years I have seen examples from iridium catalyst also. So I will tell you some important properties about those catalysts also. So first we will take Wilkinson catalyst. I will not go in detail of mechanism, right? If you want to see the mechanism of this Wilkinson catalyst, you can see my previous video based on same catalyst. So your Wilkinson catalyst is this triphenyl phosphine rhodium chloride. So we will take some important points which will be helpful for us. First point is, it will do selective reduction of double bond. Only double bond will be reduced. So there is no confusion that it will do a reduction of some functional group or not. It will do selective reduction of double bond. Right? First point is this. Next point is that cis addition of hydrogen. Then third point is mono and disubstituted double bonds will be reduced first, then tri and tetra substituted. So I will give you a series that in which order it can reduce, right? So first we will take some example based on the things we have studied so far. So here I have this double bond which is tri substituted, and this one is only mono substituted, right? So we know that only this one is reduced, this one is reduced, it will remain unaffected. Right, in this case we have here, this is disubstituted and this one is our trisubstituted. So only this one is reduced. This is very simple thing. Then we have here a functional group, so it will remain unaffected, only this one will be reduced. Right, so next point is, there is no hydrogenolysis, right? There is no hydrogenolysis, only reduction of double bonds. Then next point is, isolated double bonds will be reduced. Isolated means, suppose you have this type of a structure. So this double bond, this terminal double bond, is isolated because this was is in conjugation of this double bond, so it will be reduced first. Next point is, if you have terminal alkyne plus terminal alkene in same molecule, means you have structure like this, suppose this one, so which will be reduced first? This terminal alkyne will be reduced first. Then last point is our order of hydrogenation, that I have told you that mono substituted will be reduced first, then disubstituted for cyclic ring first, then acyclic disubstituted. So first preference will be given to geminal type of arrangement of groups, alkyl groups. Then you have next preference to Z disubstituted double bond. Then next preference will be given to trans disubstituted double bond. Then came your trisubstituted and then tetrasubstituted. So you can easily do these last two, tetra and tri. Confusion can come at this for these three, these four, right? So try to remember them. And one last important point about this Wilkinson catalyst is that it has very high affinity for CO, so it will do decarbonylation of aldehyde in preference to hydrogenation. So if you have double bond as well as CHO group present, then this CHO group present, then this CO will be removed first, hydrogenation will not take place, right? You will get this type of product, CO will be removed first. Then next catalyst is ruthenium catalyst. We have, so this catalyst, ruthenium catalyst, it will do selective reduction of mono substituted double bond. It is very effective in doing reduction of mono substituted double bond, right? And if you are taking alkynes, then it will give you Z alkene always. So this one is very, very important for mono substituted double bond. Whenever you have one or more than one double bond in a molecule, then mono substituted double bond will be reduced by this catalyst. So please look at this catalyst very carefully. Don't confuse it with Wilkinson catalyst, that in hurry you will not see. Suppose that here we have ruthenium in place of rhodium, we have ruthenium here, then your answer can be wrong. So please look at this very carefully and then use this concept. Then this one is your iridium catalyst. So first we will take its important point, that it will reduce all double bond, all type of double bond will be reduced. But question comes about its stereoselectivity. It is highly stereoselective for allylic and homoallylic double bonds, homoallylic alcohols. So what is the role of this allylic and homoallylic alcohol here? So this OH is supposed above the plane. So if I will do its hydrogenation using this iridium catalyst, then H will also attach from the same side of this oxygen. We will get this type of product. In this case, again we have this OH, but this OH is at the homoallylic position. We have one more CH2 in between this double bond and OH, right? And again we are using the iridium catalyst. So this H, the attachment side of H will be on the same side of OH, means we will get, and this carbonyl group will remain unaffected. In this case we have OH below the plane, so we will get H attached below the plane, right? So that's it. I will end today's chapter here. In next chapter we will do other type of reduction reactions. So thank you so much for watching, and if you like my videos, please share my videos with your friends. Thank you so much.